we've done a new work for the exhibition here in at the Mott, which is called Flagship Shelters, and then it has different subnames like Dior or Hugo Boss or Miu Miu, or, and the basic idea. They are small models, so they are like models of building that could possibly be built. The basic concept is that we are scaling down the flagship stores of the big brands, which especially Omoto Sanzo is very known for. We take these kind of flagship shops and we scale them down to perform the very basic of architecture, which is a shelter for a person to not be out in the rain. And in this case, it's a proposal for a specific park in Tokyo called Ueno Park, which is, among a lot of other things, also is known for that there's quite a few homeless people there. So in a way, it's taking this kind of like the flagship stores of these big brands, which are in some way you may say they're overproduced architecture, and take them back to the basic of architecture, which is like providing shelter. I think there's like different aspects of it, which is dealing with, of course, the idea of this extreme consumerism, which is also leading to people being off the grid or off society, in this case maybe homeless, but also somehow there's like threats going into this idea of a dystopia, like a meltdown of a specific kind of culture. Well, I mean, Superflex has been to Tokyo many times, and we, I guess, the first time we were here was like in the early 90s, of course, in many ways it was super interesting to be here, but it was also at the time where there was some kind of change. I think basically like the fascination about Tokyo in the beginning is this 80s. It's coming from the 80s somehow, because that's like where a lot of things were born here, and a lot of new cultural things, along that with the technology and stuff like that. And I think like moving up through the 90s, it was like more this kind of depressed times in a way, where things were stuck. I think, yeah, over time, of course, things also move. Now, it's not that everything stopped, but I think things has moved as well. And then you see in the 2000s or beginning of 2000, you have these like all the flagship stores are like from that period of time, which is kind of a symbol of the old days in a way, that this kind of extravagance or like really beautifully made buildings. And at the same time, it's also a little bit depressing, because it's not really promoting a new culture. It's promoting a brand, which is, some of them are Japanese, some of them are foreign brands, but it's like, it's not really moving things ahead, I think. And that's a bit of the problem with these kind of things. Well, I think in a way, I would like to see our work as something that looks back, but also points to a future in a way, where it may be another concern that you have to put into things. Like when you see the Miu Miu building, or it could be any other building, but Herzog de Meuron is like almost like this kind of extremely overproduced piece of architecture that in a way it becomes ridiculous, you know, in this kind of overproducedness. And maybe it's, there's something about going into details in this extreme level that kind of loses the concept. So maybe like what we want to point out is, in a way, is like how these functions, or how these ideas, if you look at them in another way, maybe you can kind of you can reestablish the concept.